In the day's other news, the Colorado Springs shooting suspect had a first court appearance in the killing of five people at a gay nightclub. During the conference call, Anderson Lee Aldrich was slumped in a wheelchair behind defense lawyers. Police say that Aldrich was beaten by nightclub patrons during the attack. The charges could include murder and hate crimes. The U.S. Justice Department reportedly wants to interview former Vice President Pence in its January 6th investigation. The New York Times and others say the focus is on then-President Trump's efforts to overturn the 2020 election results. Mr. Pence is said to be open to considering the request. In Ukraine, a new onslaught of Russian missiles knocked out power to most of the country today and claimed more lives. The airstrikes blasted Ukraine's capital, Kyiv, killing at least three people. In the south, a missile struck a hospital maternity ward and brought more tragedy.
A doctor was pulled out from under the rubble, and with the help of a ladder, a new mother was evacuated from the second floor. Unfortunately, her newborn died, who was just 2 days old.
Meanwhile, the U.S. authorized another $400 million in military aid for Ukraine, for a total of $19 billion so far. Bombs exploded today near two bus stops in Jerusalem, killing one person and wounding at least 18. The attacks came at the height of rush hour. Israeli police blame Palestinian militants, and officials closed two West Bank crossings. Later, the Israelis said that troops had killed two Palestinians in an overnight clash. In Indonesia, rescuers are still searching for survivors of Monday's earthquake that killed at least 271 people. Fire department video did show one moment of hope today. A six-year-old boy lifted to safety after being trapped for 3 days. He was found in the rubble of his home. Police in central China beat workers today as they protested over pay and anti-COVID measures outside of the world's largest Apple iPhone factory. Witnesses posted cell phone video of the confrontation. The sometimes shaky footage showed thousands of protesters at the factory. Police in hazmat suits could be seen attacking and hitting them with batons. The United Kingdom's Supreme Court has ruled that Scotland may not hold an independence vote without the British government's approval. The semi-autonomous Scottish government had wanted a referendum next October. Scotland's First Minister, Nicola Sturgeon, said today's ruling is not the end of it.
We must and we will find another democratic, lawful and constitutional means by which the Scottish people can express their will. In my view, that can only be an election. The next national election scheduled for Scotland is, of course, the UK general election.
Scottish voters rejected independence in a 2014 referendum. Britain's ruling Conservative Party has refused to approve a new vote. Back in this country, the Georgia Supreme Court today reinstated a state ban on abortions after about 6 weeks of pregnancy. It will stay in place while the court considers rulings on the merits of the law. A lower court had overturned the ban. The Georgia court also agreed today to allow early voting this Saturday in the U.S. Senate runoff. The contest features incumbent Democratic Senator Raphael Warnock against Republican Herschel Walker, a former college football and NFL star. Republicans have secured another California seat in the next U.S. House of Representatives. Kevin Kiley was declared the winner in his race last night. That gives the GOP 220 seats in the House, two more than a majority, with three races yet to be called. And on Wall Street, stocks advanced as the Federal Reserve signaled that it might scale back future interest rate hikes. The Dow Jones Industrial Average gained 96 points to close at 34,196. The NASDAQ rose nearly 111 points, 1%. The S&P 500 added 23. Still to come on the NewsHour, Congress passes a law banning non-disclosure agreements in sexual harassment cases. Taiwan's deputy foreign minister discusses his country's increasingly fraught relations with China. A training program started in New Mexico helps doctors around the world, plus much more.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington, and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.